Derek Spohn alongside Coach Chapman. Coach, how are you doing today?
I'm good, no complaints.
So it's been a tough week, back-to-back losses, but how crucial was it to get back on the practice floor today?
You know, it's everything, because once the season gets going, it's a condensed schedule. And look, we're all having to deal with that,
right.
And it's not an excuse, but it's nice to work out some kinks before we face a really good Seattle team tomorrow.
Before we get into that, let's dissect a couple of the games. The Los Angeles game, a lot of points allowed in the paint and a slow start. Were you surprised with the team's performance?
I was disappointed giving up so many points back to back. You know, we've given up 199 points in two games. You can't beat anyone doing that. So the good thing about that is it's easy to dissect the, you know, a little bit more effort, obviously, mentally being a little
right.
more locked in. And then at the end of the day, you got to get stops in this league. You can run, you know, beautiful offense, make the extra pass, but at the end of the day, we need to keep people in the 70s.
What were some positives, though, you were able to take away from that Los Angeles game?
Well, the positive is you put up 88 points at home after you've been off for 4 or 5 days. Normally, you think your offense is not moving. So that was a positive there. And I like having to go to work on the defensive end of the floor.
And I know Atlanta had a great free throw shooting night that night as well. But the Atlanta game as well, a lot of turnovers, second chance opportunities. What happened with the Atlanta game?
Well, I think it was our transition defense was not there. I thought that, you know, they killed us on the boards. 19. We never got out of the gate. You know, even
right.
in the LA game, we got down low, then we cut it to 9, cut it to 8. We never got any traction in Atlanta. And I give Atlanta credit, but I also can dissect it enough to know what part we played in that.
And a tough shooting night for Atlanta, but the return of Epiphany Prince. With that, what were some other positives you were able to take away from Atlanta and apply moving forward?
Well, you know, anytime you lose, as disappointing as it is, you get a lot of, you know, video to
right.
correct some things. It's also an opportunity to put a little bit more responsibility on the players that aren't necessarily starting the game, but are playing, you know, maybe 10, 12 minutes, maybe have them hone in, because a lot of times you always go to the superstar players. But I think for us, we've been successful because players 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 have stepped in. So you can kind of separate that and,
yeah.
and make sure those players understand how important they are. The return of Epiphany Prince was nice, you know. She played 10
yeah.
minutes, scored 7 points. She looks good. You know, she dropped about 12, 14 pounds, so she's moving really well. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's nice to have her back, but we know moving forward, we're going to need that bench and we're going to need some better defense.
Was that flowing, that chemistry there early, would you say, or were they still trying to adjust having the different players on the court with Epiphany? Or?
No, you know, she's a veteran player. She's a lot like Allie in that she can catch and shoot.
Right.
She spaces the floor. She's a little bit better in the pick and roll. So that part wasn't difficult. It's maybe new for new players, and that would probably be a Jamira Faulkner.
Okay.
Because she's a point, but when she's playing with Sloot and others, it's an easy adjustment.
Just a couple more questions here for you. Seattle coming to town tonight, a team that's looking for a win. You guys are looking for a win. What will be the key to that victory?
Well, you know, Seattle's a good team. They're the team that upset Minnesota.
Yeah.
They're coming in, they're riding on a high. They play really good defense. They're going to want to keep the game in the 60s and slow you down. They're going to play long into the shot clock. You know, they take a lot of shots under 8 seconds. So you're going to make sure, we have to make sure the area that we've been really, really bad the last couple of games, we have to, you know, really tune it in because they're going to make the extra pass. They're going to run some continuity. So we're going to have to be on our game.
And my final question for you, what is the latest on Sylvia Fowler's status?
Sylvia, today she actually did some 5-on-0 non-contact stuff.
Okay.
You know, if you ask Sylvia, she has her own time frame to return, which is a lot quicker.
Yeah.
But we also want to remind her, look, you're rounding third and you're halfway home. Let's continue to be smart. But she looked good today. She felt good. So we're going to just keep progressing slowly.
That's what you got to do. Well, Derek Spohn, Coach Chapman, wish you the best of luck tomorrow.
Thank you, man.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
It. All right.